Yesterday was April Fool's Day, but students at St. Francis School in Harbour Grace found out that administration wasn't joking about the tech ban. Mobile phones, tablets, and other personal devices were no longer allowed on school premises. The school says it's because of behavioral issues and distractions.
They're not getting their education in class. They're too interested in their cell phones and texting, and it shouldn't be allowed in class.
I know one young fellow who's been taped and everything else. You know, these things are good, but I think they should be used at the proper place at the proper time.
The ban was announced on Sunday via a Facebook post from the school. While it may be quite an adjustment for some students, others, not so much.
He just got a cell phone about a week ago, and he took it to school Friday for the first time, and then the ban came out, so I thought that was great. I don't know if he'll agree.
You might be surprised to learn he does, at least while Grandma's around.
I think it's a really good idea because people that are older, they look up pretty inappropriate and bad stuff.
Most people I spoke to understood the problems that cell phones can cause in a classroom, but others wondered if forcing students to leave their technology at home was a step too far.
I'm a single parent. I have a daughter that leaves school on the bus each day, and she calls me each day on the way home from bus. And she says, okay, I'm going in the house now. Okay, I'm in the house. I'm feeling safe. Door's locked. Everything's good.
The lack of communication is an anxiety she shares with her 13-year-old daughter.
Practically to be safe outside of school and to go to Splash or a friend's house, you can't go to the office and ask for that because that should be planned outside of school, but sometimes you can't predict that.
Now it seems the policy that had everyone talking might have been rushed out the gate. After just one day in effect, the school announced it will be reversing the ban, at least until they do further consultation with district staff, school council, and the broader school community. Stephen Miller, CBC News, Harbour Grace.